my little crones, my little munchkins, and my little chickens. How are you this fine midweek day? Well, I hope you're doing great. I hope you're doing grand, considering all the stuff that's going on in the news, above and below. Well, it's good to see you again. And as always, subscribe, 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 and thumbs up me. So as I go on with our midweek recap, to be honest with you, there really isn't much going on at all. Ooh, other than the download that Ray J gave. Now that's, ooh, so we're gonna definitely talk about that. I definitely wanna talk about something. Some of you may not know about this, but I wanna talk about it. At least give me a minute. I don't know, but I gotta ask. Say it's not so, baby crumb.
What?
Did Tasha K really snuck out of town and go to Morocco?
Yes, she did.
What in the fudge sickles is going on? 2022, that six has been a hell of a year. Everything is being exposed. Tasha K, tell me she went on a vacation for about 2 weeks in
yes,
Africa.
Let's hope so and not flee the country.
Tell me she ain't kept. Tell me all that muffling. You know I adore Tasha K. You tell me with all that mouth. Please tell me that she was like the big bad wolf saying, I'm gonna go up against Cardi B. Ain't nothing gonna take me down. Tell me that ain't so. Tell me she didn't get rid of her house or put it on the market or whatever she did. Because if they found out that she's gone to Africa. Huh?
I said exactly. They find out she skipped out on
the
country.
They will take the house, right? I have no idea of the law. Those that know about the law, tell me about it. Because I'm in the esoteric things. And what I do, I tell you about what's going to happen before it happened. If you go back just a couple of days ago, I told you that don't get the black men to talking. Because when they talk, what I tell them, baby, from?
Yes.
I tell you, see, there are some people that are historians. There are some people, they are good with putting out news. Everybody has their gift in this. What I am, I'm the seer. I see what's going on, and so I put it out there in advance. So sometimes when people get it, I don't already hit on it already. Okay? Just like this, I don't even know if this is even appropriate, getting off of Tasha for a moment. Going on to Chloe, were they not at the Beyonce party? Did I not tell you the heart loves what the heart wants? You know, that's why she's laying low. My point that I want to know, we'll get back to it later, but I want to know how much did they know? How much did the little girls know? How much did Chloe and Courtney know? However, Courtney probably knew a lot more. Why? Because Courtney was the one that took the new pictures with Chloe, with Kim. Now, I believe it was more than that because he said the video. Mm-hmm. They very freaky girls. The kind you don't take home to mother. Anyway, I'm sorry. I still love them. I know that they were young, but let me get off of them for a second. Okay, so with that being said, my question with all of this is, where is, what's his name? Yee. Mm-hmm. Yeezy. Where is Yeezy? Where is Yeezy? Well, Yeezy was nowhere but up where? In New York?
No.
Paris?
Yes, Paris.
He was in Paris in an outstanding fashion show. He was busy. He was busy. He didn't get tangled up in this. And then I heard a rumor that, that him and Ray J was, what were they saying? Both sharing. I don't know. I haven't seen it. I haven't heard it. I think he's doing the right thing. Just mellow out on this. My only hope is that Ray J take this to court. So the world can see the charlatans, the fake. They even have a church. Well, let me get on. See, there really isn't no other news. So this, let me just send this up. I know at this moment that Tiffany Haddish, right? And what's his name? Something Spear.
Aries.
I know they are shuffling like, oh, they ain't talking about us. I they doing a cha-cha-ta. They speaking in tongues. Boogaloo, boogaloo, woogaloo. I know they're happy. Oh my God, because this has just blown our minds. However, I don't think that we're shocked the fact that they blew our minds. I don't think that's it, because I think a lot of us speculated so much along the years anyway. I think what's blowing the minds. Now, however, I'm a small YouTube station. However, I'm small, but I'm on point. All right? Because you got some power hitters in there. I thought that what's her name? Frankel. What's her name?
Bethany.
Because, you know, I think she's sharp. I think she's witty. I mean, she's been talking about this for some time. Because I didn't know that, you know, because I don't really go and listen to everybody. And besides, Bethany is a white woman. I didn't think that she would care. She's up for new money. I didn't think that she would absolutely care. She's the one that's just skinny margarita. So I didn't think, and she was from the Housewives of New York. So I think it was New York, but nevertheless, I didn't just think that she would be anywhere interested. However, she's on Ray J's side, and she's been talking about them for months, or not years. She said because there was rumors going out about them a long time ago, and she put things in perspective. However, I didn't know that Owens, what's her name?
Candace
Owens. And I know she gets a lot of bad rap from people. I understand that. But see, I like her. So I like both of them. So I admire that they both, powerful women indeed, with voices, are speaking out about this foolery. As little baby Cone would say, this foo-foo. Foolishness. So, to when you hear the foo-foo, foolery, that's what I call it. Baby call it foo-foo, I call it foolery. At the end of the day, it's foolishness. And it leads me to think, if Ray J popped off like this because of the pressure, imagine what they must have put Kanye through. If there wasn't nothing much clearer to me, is this. Kanye fell in love with a fraud. He loved her. He loved her. And how do I know? Because they showed a clip when she was talking to, what's his name?
Who? Ray J?
No, Kim. She was talking to the boy and one of her sisters, Scott. And she was saying how wonderful. Now I'm sick and tired of a woman keep saying how wonderful a man is, how good he's been. He's wonderful. I just don't have it for him anymore. I just don't love him. Whoo! How can love just come and go like that? He served his purpose. She got her 4 years, and as far as she's concerned, I'm locked on that money. She trapped them, and all of them had babies that can by these black men to trap them, to hold on, to get their kids into places like, I want my child tall, so let me make sure I get a tall man. Huh, Chloe? Come on, tell the truth.
Yeah, because I started thinking about it, because I was just
there
like,
is no
man.
Coincidence with this. This all was orchestrated. Momager's been Momager.
Yes, we could see why Kanye is worried now.
I see it.
About his kids being around Kim, especially Chris, as influencers.
Because if you would do that to your own daughter, he's like, what is my kids? And you know Kim is scrupulous. But what's her name, Owens? What's her name?
Candace.
Called her a prostitute. Straight up. You know what I call them. Ho! There's some hoes in their house. There's some hoes. I mean, that will do anything for money. They'll do anything for clout. And the thing that really, and I hope that the black men wake up when you meet this kind of a white woman. You can go on and say she's half black. You can go on. She knows so very little about black. Because if she know what I know, she wouldn't have slept with all those black men. Her background don't look good. You know, you could have slept with 1,000 men if you're a woman, but you don't let it show. And I had said before this happened, I had said that don't let them start talking. I mean, she has been with men I can't even believe, like Omari, no, who was he?
The King.
She was with him. But the other one who I said they looked like Lil Bow Wow and, you know who I'm talking about.
Yes, I do.
It's just coming out. And it seems like her husband, her first husband, loved her. He loved her. But she wanted to get over on him because she started cheating. It seems like she has a type. She likes dark men. Not very tall, but muscular. She has a type. And when she gets them, for whatever reason, after they serve their purposes, she doesn't use them anymore. She seems more like a incubus or a succubus, whatever one for the female. She's an incubus. That's a demonic spirit. It's an entity that comes in the body of women. And what it does is seduce men. And when they get the men all seduced in their head, all wrapped up, then they devour. They take their souls. And a man, I think, is a succubus. He sucks all the things, and these things work while you're asleep. So what do you mean? These demonic energies, they put you in a sleeping state. You're awake, but they have you in a sleeping state as they perform this on you. Okay, baby phone is laughing.
No,
but trust me, there are spirits. Oh, you saw it. See, there are spiritual vampires. See, you got to look at things there. You can't see these things with the natural, but you know them by their characteristics.
Mm-hmm. I just want to put it out there that what I saw was the rumors of them saying that the movie Get Out was designed for Kanye. And when he was talking about the hypnotized, I was seeing the woman steering the drink.
Yeah.
And how mesmerizing it can be and how sunken you can get in that. And I'm just like, damn, Kanye needs to get out.
I mean, at this point, Chloe's in a sunken place. Mm. When you're in a sunken place, that means that your mind is so connected to that thing, that person, whatever it was, that you no longer can see your way clear. You're helpless. You are led by your total emotions. Your heart is fully out there. And you are slave to that thing or person that you love. And until you can get a grip of it or be strong, because it's hard to break the chain. It's hard to break a chain. A sturdy chain with length. You understand? So, with that being said, I want to talk about a lot of news, but as you can see, there really isn't very much to talk about other than this. Like I said, I really do appreciate Candace Owens for speaking out. She really went in there. And not only Candace, a lot of us, all of us, and some of us been down here talking about this a long time. I know I've been talking about it for the last 6 months. I came on the scene and a gangster and a lean talking about this. You know, I've been talking about it. But I came in talking about the fact that their kingdom was coming down. I came in telling you. I came in telling you we need a Messiah, somebody that's going to make everything all right. Oh, but I understand this. But this is what I have to say. You all know that I look at the Bible. I was a devout Christian at one point in my life. And it's so hard not to, when you've been indoctrinated and not indoctrinated, getting away from the indoctrination and looking at things for what they are. It is kind of curious to me that the Bible says that in the latter days, and when the time end, like when time come to an end, and not time like we know it, I'm sure, you know, but I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about, like, Baby Cone, say what I'm trying to say.
Saying you're talking about how curious it is that what the Bible depicts the end days will look like.
Right.
Or the signs of what to look for at the end days, yet it's not real.
It's real in a sense, but the end days, like the world is coming to an end. No, the whole age is coming to an end because we're evolving into a new age. A new heightened sense of enlightenment. I've been speaking on this for...
So then I have a question.
Yes.
Are they going to then revamp the Bible for that new age?
That Bible is for this age.
So they're not going to have a Bible.
Listen, I don't know. I'm not the future, babe.
I'm just trying to say.
Not the future. I don't know. But this is what I can tell you.
Okay.
The Bible is like any other book. It's there for correction. It's there for guidance. Mm-hmm. If you don't know about what is a sin or what is right, I like to say right or wrong. What is right or wrong, you can look in the Bible. If you need a God or you need something to worship because you lost, go to the Bible. Any holy book. Any legitimate holy book. I don't want to just say the Bible because that leads out to Tanakh and it leads out to Torah and it leads out the... what the Islam Bible is called? This is terrible.
Quran.
Thank you. Because you weren't going to let me be embarrassed. Thank you. Because I know this. So, with the Quran. So, out of those three books in America, and if you, I would say Buddhism, but they don't deal with that. So these are the three religions. And so I'm saying, I know in the Christian Bible, it talks about a beast or some kind of beast is going to rise up. And it talks about this beast is called Babylon, the mother of harlots. This is what they call them. And I think this beast have other beasts, or this beast supposed to have a prophet or a sidekick. And they always talking about this spirit, Jezebel spirit. The church is always talking about a Jezebel spirit. And here we've been seduced by this beast. Go ahead, Baby Crumb, like that. Go ahead, Baby Crumb.
Yes, I did. That was good.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was just like, you're right. Kim Kardashian is like the beast.
She's a beast. Not a beast in appearance. A beast in her mind. A beast in, I will do anything. I will trample over you. I will marry you. I will lie on you. I will cut your throat. I will trample over my sister if she got in the way of what I want. That's a beastly mentality. A beast mentality means even though I have so much, I'm not going to stop taking. I'm going to get so fat till I topple over and just die from engorgement. That a beast that has no care. And I don't know if it's true, but I hear that the Armenian people right now are crying out to Kim Kardashian to help them. What can she do? She is not a god. She is not the president, the vice president. She is not nowhere in the House of Representatives. She can't do a thing but send y'all money. And they're begging for her. Why do I say that? Because that's how big she is. A beast. That at the end of the day, her and Little Beast, her sidekick, her favorite one, the thorn in her side, the hot one, the one that started having sex at 14. Her, could have been 13 because you know she a liar. You know? And I know one thing, those girls are a splitting image of their mother. I'm talking about all of them, even the two baby girls. And I'm telling you that this is a beastly system. And everybody is like, I don't know if Ray J is going to win. I don't know. Because the Kardashian is so powerful. You know what? I know they could be the most powerful people on earth. But one thing power can't do, it can't put out truth. Truth is truth. And it is the truth that makes one free. And right now, those Kardashian are not saying anything. And as Ray J said, if I'm wrong, come after me. If that's not a silent, they went too far. Kimberly, you went too far with your pink up there crying. And especially when you got me with the blocks? What is it?
The Roblox.
Oh, man, I believed it. Till Baby Crone told me it wasn't no sex thing can go on there. Thank you, Baby Crone, for keeping me here. So, again, because I can't even believe it. Again, you sure the algorithms are different. They can't, no naked, no pictures, no nothing of Kim could show up in there. That would be scandalous.
A picture can show up, yes. Like it has like a shirt that they could wear. It's like a t-shirt. They could put it up like it has a picture.
No. It's got to be something because it poured her to tears.
Oh, no, they can only show like a picture, not like a video.
But nothing disgusting or vulgar for a kid to see.
No, because hopefully it will get flagged and removed because it will be inappropriate.
Okay, definitely. Because the way it was explained to me is that the algorithm wouldn't even let it go through anyway.
Right, you're right, it wouldn't because they always...
It's on such a whole nother algorithm that it just wouldn't even allow it to go
through. Yes, because they always verify a picture you upload anyway to make sure it's not derogatory.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. It's not like Facebook.
Mm-mm, no, okay. It gets scanned before it gets put
Facebook,
up.
Because Facebook, you can get out there. Mm-hmm. Look behind you. Is she behind you? No. Okay, sorry about that. So, okay. Well, anyway, I got way off course. That was just a moment of realness. But nevertheless, getting back to this is all I had. Right now, I really can't talk on Tiffany Haddish. I'll try to knock that out on when we get to the Brown Round the weekend. As far as this, I would like to know what is going on. And this, I in my spirit, down deep inside of me, there was a part of me, I'm going to say it, that I was hoping that Kanye and that Kim would eventually get back together. Even though I saw the disdain that she has for him. Even though I heard her say the Scotch just don't have it for him and how wonderful he is. You know? And I know what it's like. I guess we all do know what it's like to be with somebody and if they just turn you off. And when he wanted to come home, she said, no, bring an overnight bag. And Scott said, this is your husband. You know that, right? And she was like, I know. But yet, you know what? D.L. Hughley and that African guy, the light-skinned guy, you know who he is. All those men that spoke out against Kanye and saying how horrible of a person. Seems like you got duped too. Seems like now you understand that it was all a play to make him go crazy. And I know you all, what's his name gonna come to me? That light-skinned brother, he was African, he do a night show. His name will come to me. And it's so, they were so quick to turn down. But now they really see the damage that they do to black men. So just imagine, because Kanye went crazy out, she's trying to kill my baby. She did this, she did that. So they have a way of doing something that will mess your head up. And just like for me, I followed them. If they was going to hell and I was right there following, right on in that burning flame of, I want to be like that. I want to go there. I want to do this. I want this. I was a part until I woke up. They are very powerful. But I believe nothing can be truth. Because I believe it's the truth that makes one free. I believe that. And I believe that he went out there and he put it before the world. So now if it should go to court, which I hope that it does, because it needs to go down in history that it was judged by the law. And with the backing of the public, yes, there are going to be people that's going to stand against Kim, because right now people are, because those are people that just want to be lost. Let them be lost. But who that want a truth and believe in truth, I believe in it not because it's Ray J. I owe Ray J an apology. Because I thought he was a dog. And so anything that he went to a woman, I even thought he beat women. I thought he was a perv. Because that's what she dared me to believe. Even when she came back with the same old story. And even Chloe said, this sounds like a repeat from the beginning. If I was Chloe and I was them, I will bail ship. This will be my last season and I will be out. Because what they have done, they have oversaturated themselves. And I said, we talked about it. I said they oversaturated themselves. They don't know when. They don't know. I got to say something that Kevin Hart would say. They don't know when to say pineapples. 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 They don't know when. That's because they are possessed. Their spirit is being consumed. And they don't know how to say when. So it would have to be something. And as I said, and I will stand on it, I'm telling you through all of this, Kim will not go down. She says, I'm a weeble and a wobble, but I won't fall down. You're going to knock her down. She's coming down. It has to come down. Too much corruption. I don't care who the powers, because above ground, they're not talking about this on CNN. They're not talking about this on MSNBC. They're not talking about this. Mm-mm. Not yet. It's up to Ray J. And I really hope that he takes it to court. And I hope this be the case of a century, because we surely can use some serious, serious drama right now. It seems like I love it when America go to court. When we were in court, we were in court for all the major things. We just come together as a people. Of course, lines are drawn. You know, you have your lines. But it's also a good time because it's something about it when America go to court.
Yes, because they want justice, because they take it serious mm-hmm. then.
And the lines are drawn. Mm-hmm. All those on the Kardashians will be on the Kardashian side. Right. And all those on Ray J will be on Ray J. And all those that says, I really don't care, be right there in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
I love it. I love it when we go to court. But not for that only. I just want it because I want it to be written down in stone. And I want it to be no doubt. I want it to be no doubt that Ray J spoke the truth. So with that being said, I went on and I went on. But thank you, my little munchkins, my little crones, my little chickens. I just wanted to do a midday recap. Ciao!